Hey guys, this is Billy Davidson with Davidson Pressure Washing coming from Hammond, Louisiana. I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the setup of these high flow machines. We're just getting started early this morning. And some of the people are calling me from around the country want to know, you know, the setup procedures. So I'm going to go over that real quick and maybe this might help some of y'all out. First of all, we start feeding the tank with a water supply. As you can see up top there, that orange color hose of water supply going into it. Ideally, when I'm running both machines, I would like to double feed the tank, if at all possible, from two separate spigot locations. In today's situation, our next spigot is 700 feet away, so it's not feasible to do that. So what I've done this morning, I've filled the tank as the tank is filling. I guess right now it's probably got about 135, 140 gallons in it. And at that point, I'll go ahead and start the machines and start the purging. What I mean by purging is letting, after sitting overnight, you get air bubbles in the lines. You want to get that out before you actually connect the pressure hoses and grab those machines up. So on this number two machine, I got it just on the idle, and I got the throttle all the way down, and I got the pressure side off. And that's just basically purging any air. Or if I happen to have any debris in it, it would be flushing it out. I'd rather it come out now while the machine's on idle with no pressure involved. That way it just blow itself out. And also, this machine as well, I got it throttled all the way down, just at a basically loping. And these are 24 horsepower, 8 gallon a minute machines, rated at 3,500 PSI. This machine also is flushing itself out. Just sit here and let them idle, making sure no air is in the line or no sort of debris. Also, another good thing about let them idle for a few minutes, when you have a cold morning like this morning, we were in the mid-30s. I'd rather them just sit there and sort of warm up, let the oil warm up in them, let the pump oil warm up, and actually before we start going to a full throttle setting.
So anyway, I hope this helps, and
if you need any